Hi guys, it's Jess from Modest Fiction, and welcome back to my channel. So if you are familiar with my channel, you might recognize this clip.
Hey guys, I recently finished reading A Court of Thorns and Roses, and it left me with a massive book hangover. But instead of sitting on the couch being bummed, I scoured the internet for another amazing series similar to A Court of Thorns and Roses. Stick around to see what I picked to cure my book hangover.
So today I'm going to be doing the exact same thing. I actually made a part two of that video, and today I'm going to be doing part three. So stick around to hear my ACOTAR book recommendations. All right, guys. So like I said in the intro, I have two other videos that are recommending books that are similar to A Court of Thorns and Roses. I highly suggest checking both of those out before proceeding. I will post a link in the cards in the description for those two. But similar to those videos, I'm going to be discussing five different books that I feel have similar vibes and feelings to A Court of Thorns and Roses, whether they feature Faye, have a slow burn romance, or just have that angst. So I will be discussing the book. I will give a full spoiler-free synopsis of each book, then why I feel like it will help cure your ACOTAR hangover. Now, if you're unfamiliar with my channel, I post new videos every Thursday and Sunday. If you haven't, please like and subscribe. You can also hit the notification bell to be notified whenever I post new bookish content. And you can also check out my Instagram. It is linked down in the description below. And with that being said, let's get into the list. All right, the first book up on this list is actually the book that inspired me to make this video. This book is so similar to ACOTAR in the best of ways, and that is These Hollow Vows, and this is by Lexi Ryan. This was released a little bit earlier this year, and oh my gosh, the similarities. So this follows Bree, who is a thief who's living kind of an impoverished life. She's just trying to get by, and she knows that in her world, people sometimes sell themselves to the Fae. However, Bree is so anti-Fae, she wants nothing to do with them, which is very unfortunate when her little sister is stolen by the King of the Unseelie Court. So Bree ends up traveling to the Fae world where she meets the Prince of the Seelie Court and they start to have a connection, but she also meets a group of misfits from the Unseelie Court who help her train and figure out how to use her abilities. And the story goes from there. I loved this. This had so many elements of ACOTAR. I actually made an entire video of the similarities between These Hollow Vows and ACOTAR that I will leave linked in the cards. But if you want a love triangle, very Tamlin Reese-esque, highly recommend. There's a love triangle in These Hollow Vows that I think is done to perfection. There's also the similarities with the different courts, the different politics between the different courts. I can't even think off the top of my head. There's just so many. Obviously, you have that Rhysand character, the dark character, which I absolutely loved. Oh my gosh, this book was just perfection. And I think if you're someone who really did enjoy ACOTAR, you will highly enjoy this. I will say this reads a little bit younger than ACOTAR did. I feel like as ACOTAR progressed, the stories became much more complex. There's a lot more politicking. This reads a bit younger. However, this is just the beginning of a series. So I think as this series progresses, it could also add more complexity and become just as immersive as ACOTAR. So I can't wait to see what happens in this series. All right, the next book is a YA fantasy and it is Kingdom of the Curse. Now this is the second book in a series, starting off with Kingdom of the Wicked. So I'm going to give you a synopsis of Kingdom of the Wicked in order not to ruin or spoil this book. However, I'm gonna give you the reasons why I feel that if you like ACOTAR, specifically A Court of Mist and Fury, A Kingdom of the Cursed is 100% for you. There are so many similarities. So Kingdom of the Wicked follows Amelia, who is a witch, that in the very beginning of the book, a tragedy takes place and she needs to solve a murder. So while trying to solve this murder, she accidentally summons one of the princes of Hell, Wrath. So Amelia has grown up her entire life being told, do not trust the seven princes of hell, who happen to be named after the seven deadly sins. And Wrath does not want to work with a witch. He also has his reservations about witches in general. And we find out more about that later. So these two end up being bonded together against their will, similar to some other characters in ACOTAR. And they work together to solve this problem. And it goes from there. So Kingdom of the Curse actually takes place in hell. So Wrath and Amelia are now venturing together and trying to navigate the different princes of hell. However, Emilia doesn't know what Rath's motivations are. He's this very stoic character that has been taught or has been feared by everyone in hell. Everyone has these horrible stories about how terrible he is, and she's starting to see a different side of him, similar to some characters we know from ACOTAR. So I loved this book so much. Like I said, this is NA, so there are some spicier scenes in this, but this is essentially Under the Mountain. So think if A Court of Mist and Fury took place all under the mountain, that's what we're getting here. And I loved it so, so much. I loved the slow burn romance. I loved the complexities. Also in Kingdom of the Wicked, you have two people being bonded together that absolutely hate each other and having to deal with each other. There's tattoos. That's a similarity, kind of random. But overall, I think that if you really enjoyed ACOTAR, you will definitely enjoy Kingdom of the Wicked and Kingdom of the Cursed. This next one is a little bit of a stretch as far as very similar to ACOTAR. However, if you enjoy Beauty and the Beast retellings as much as I do, I think you'll absolutely love this book. It is an adult fantasy, and it is For the Wolf by Hannah Witten. So this, like I said, is a Beauty and the Beast retelling, and it's following two sisters, and the firstborn is for the throne, and the second one is for the wolf, and we're following both perspectives. The setting in this is done so well. It's just very autumnal and eerie, and the girl that is for the wolf ends up being sentenced to go through this dark, malevolent forest and be given to the wolf. And no one knows what happens to these girls when that happens. They assume they're sacrificed. So Red, our main character, is the girl that is sacrificed, but she manages to get through this wood somehow and meets the wolf. And the wolf is actually a man, not this evil being. And he kind of teaches her how to use her power. And they form this connection, even though she is being forced to stay with him against her will. Then we're also following the older sister, who is for the throne, as she is dealing with all of these politics and trying to figure out how to get her younger sister back. And it is so much fun. I think this is the perfect book if you want a romance, but also it has some deep scheming and a beautiful setting. I loved this book. It got very mixed review on Goodreads, and I'm not really sure why, because I think it's the best of both worlds, and I just highly recommend picking this up. And next up is a YA fantasy that was released earlier this year. And if you end up enjoying it, the second book just came out, so perfect timing. And that is The Prison Healer by Lynette Nani. And this follows Kiva. And Kiva, when she is very young, is sent to this prison known as Zalandov. And no one ever survives in this prison, but luckily Kiva is a gifted medic and ends up becoming the prison healer. So Kiva spends her time and she is able to survive, I believe, 10 years in this prison. All the while, she's getting notes from her family that are saying, be patient, we're coming to save you. So she's just biding her time until one day, the rebel queen is captured and sent to Zalandov. And in her pocket is a note from Kiva's family that says, keep her alive, we're coming. Unfortunately, this rebel queen has just been sentenced to do these elemental trials that no one has ever survived. So Kiva decides she's going to take her place and do these trials. And hopefully, she makes it out okay. I loved this book so much. It was such a fun time. Now you might be thinking, how does this relate to ACOTAR? So if you enjoyed ACOTAR, the first book, Under the Mountain, when Farrah has to do all of these different trials, essentially this entire book is that. It's Kiva going through these trials and just trying to survive. And one of my favorite parts of ACOTAR was when Farrah was going against the Midgard worm and all of those things she does under the mountain. So much fun, and this book is just that. So if you like that part of the book, I would check this out. Even if not, this is a very, very fun YA fantasy, and like I said, the second book was just released, so definitely check this out. All right, guys, so I saved the best for last. This last series is my new obsession. I adore it so much, and please wait for me to explain the difference or the similarities between ACOTAR and the series before you pass judgment. I know a lot of people aren't so crazy about the series, but I just love it. And that is The Zodiac Academy by Susan Valenti and Carolyn Peckman. So this follows Tori and Darcy Vega that on their 18th birthday, they find out that they're actually Fae royalty. But in order to claim their inheritance, they have to go through this Fae Academy. So they are whisked off to the Fae area. And when they get to the Academy, they find out that there are these four elemental heirs that are ruling the school and don't want to deal with these two Vega twins. So it is a bullying romance, and oh my goodness, This series has everything. So if you want slow burn romance, you got it. You want enemies to lover, you got it. You want love triangle, you have it. It is full of tension. It is just, oh my gosh, you want Faye, you have it. You want a brooding vampire that is misunderstood, but is only nice to one person. It's so good. I love this series. I will say, the first book is my least favorite, I think, and that's very odd for me. Typically, the first book is what gets me into a series, and then as the series progresses, like, I just get more and more into it. I didn't love the first one. I think the writing was a little not so great. Very basic, very easy to understand. However, it was okay. There are some references to, like, Faye book and some things that are a little cringy, but overall, like I said, as the series goes, you just fall in love with these characters. These characters are so multidimensional, and you just fall in love with their different relationships, and the side characters are even written so well, and it's so good. Unfortunately, this series is not finished yet, so I believe there are two more books that are still coming out. I know one book is going to be released in December that I'm anxiously awaiting, and then I think there might be one more after that, but definitely recommend. If you enjoyed ACOTAR, I think you will really enjoy this series. All right, guys, that is it for my books that will help carry your A Court of Thorns and Roses hangover. At the time of filming this, I've already read A Court of Thorns and Roses 4 times, and I know it can be rough. So I hope these books help alleviate the pain a little bit. If there are any other books you think are similar to ACOTAR, please leave them in the comments down below. I would love to check them out. And with that being said, I said this already, but I post new videos every Thursday and Sunday, and I will see you all next week. Bye.